Okay.
Dear Uncle Tacitus, I do so hope you enjoyed your vacation. Lucky you, leaving like that. And you always suggested you were too old for travel. I hope you and your cousins enjoyed yourselves. Me and your grandnieces have decided to take a trip of our own, as the place has become so dreary and godforsaken in your absence. We've gone to visit relatives. From my daddy's side, you are not yet acquainted with them. In Lacay, a small village just north of Saint-Denis. It's buggy and muggy, but apparently neither is too bad at this time of year. Please come see us when you can. Yours sincerely, Caroline.
Well, thank you, darling niece Caroline. I guess I'm coming to see you in Lacay.
Melton keeps sending us back every day to search this place.
There quite clearly isn't a gang of outlaws held up here.
Someone is here. Look, those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around, then. See if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poisonous snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Orley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
Arthur's here.
Oh, Arthur, oh, you're alive.
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
How y'all doing? Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sisica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Okay.
How'd you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
It was Mrs. Adler who saved us, Dutch. After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates of her living here.
Mrs. Adler, we owe you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah.
We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pinkerton Detective Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall, Kerosene, and Tar, the United States government, and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually,
let him have it.
Everyone get down!
Ask everyone you could find!
Arthur, follow me!
This is real bad.
Stay down, Ollie! Shit!
Arthur, follow me! This way! There's a trapdoor into the other house! We can try to flank them!
Oh, me and Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure.
We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch?
Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier, you and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days. Now, please, gentlemen.
What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're gonna have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you gonna do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
Well, we'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not gonna come to that.
Dutch!
Not now, Mesa. Not now.
I'm begging you to. They're gonna hang him and break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay, I'm gonna go figure out how we rescue this bastard.
Now?
Yes, now. Meet me at Doyle's Tavern on Million Avenue.
Okay. My lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything. Not sure what happens next. Whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we've gone through. I'm starting to wish we'd stayed on Guam.
I didn't lead them here, Morgan. I swear it.
It don't matter either way. Well, try to keep your head straight.
Okay, Arthur.
Good to see you again, Uncle. So, Molly ain't around?
No, not for a while now. You boys sure returned with a bang.
And we always seem to these days. Okay. Guess I'll leave you to it, then. Glad to be home?
I almost wish we were back in Guarma.
I know. Well, don't give up on everything just yet.
Okay.
Reverend, it's good to see you again.
You too. But this is a mess. A real mess.
All of you, come along! Mr. Pearson!
Good to see you again, Mr. Strauss.
Are you coming along there?
I'm moving as fast as possible.
Well, good! All of you, hurry this along! We need to go! Do you want those men to come back and murder us once and for all? No? Then hurry up! We need to get moving again! Quick! All of you!
Good to see you again.
What do we do now?
Morning.
Long day ahead.
How are you doing?
Well, I'll soldier through.
It's good to see you again, despite the circumstances.
You too. But what do we do now?
We need to move. Soon as possible. We've got a couple of days. Anyway, I'll leave you to it.
Sure,
good
okay.
Good to see you again, Karen. Where's Molly, by the way?
Nobody's seen her in ages. Good riddance, I say.
Huh. Okay. How you doing, Jack?
I'm scared, Uncle Arthur. All that shooting.
Well, we're gonna move somewhere safe, okay? Okay. Guess I'll see you later, then.
Yeah, sure.
Some reunion, huh?
Well, at least you're alive.
Hello, boy. Okay. Guess I'll leave you to it, then.
Sure.
You okay, Abigail?
What are we gonna do? We can't stay here.
I know. I'll speak to Dutch. Well, don't give up on everything just yet.
White, two, D4, black. To F, 5. White to G, 3. Knight to F, 6. Bishop to G, 2. Black to G, 6. Knight to F, 3. White to D, 4. Black to F.
You okay there?
Working it all out. Once and for all, Arthur.
What now?
We're back, and I'm sitting here, and I am contemplating the great journey of the sun and considering a famous chess move. Those Oilean actors of a mediocre justice, the Pinkertons, and their benefactor, the depressing millionaire Leviticus Cornwall, they want us, Arthur. They want us. And they are going to have us.
Maybe they ain't the problem.
Meaning?
I don't know. It's just, well, I can't help but feel we would have been better running off someplace else.
But the game ain't over, Arthur. I mean, I ain't played my final move, but
I guess I'm more interested in saving lives than winning a chess.
And maybe life ain't such a thing to cling on to so tightly.
No doubt. What about the women?
You sound like Hosea. I miss him.
I asked you a question.
What do you think?
We can't stay here. That much is obvious. Where are we gonna run to? I mean, they chased us from the west. They chased us over the mountains. They ran us into the sea.
Arthur, do you have my back?
Always, Dutch. But there's more than your back to worry about. We need more money. We've been on the run for months now, and I seen you killing folk in cold blood like you always told me not to. And I'm sorry, but I can't help but think that if we
there is country in Roanoke Ridge past Butcher Creek, I believe we could hold.
Okay.
You and Charles, you could take folks up that way.
Micah
and I need to do some reconnaissance. I ain't got a final plan yet. Arthur, I ain't got it. I just need time. I need time and no traitors.
Charles. Be right with me.
Always. Where are we headed?
Up past Butcher Creek.
It's Murphy Brute Country.
That's why I'm asking you to ride with me.
I understand.
You okay?
What are we doing there?
We're looking for a place to hole up. Even the law won't follow us up there too willingly.
Yeah, I did some scouting up there while your boys were away.
And?
We'll see.
I know the way. Follow me.
Back out there, girl. We need to get this done fast. The Pinkertons will have reinforced in another day or two.
Yeah. The sooner we get out of here, the better. It's quite a ride up there. I saw some canoes near the bridge upriver, which would take us right up to Butcher Creek. Might be quicker. What do you think?
Whoa. Yeah, a boat's probably a good idea.
Okay, good.
It's good to see you again, Charles.
You too.
Thanks for what you did in Saint-Denis. Real brave drawing them off us like that. I was worried you and Abigail had both got yourselves killed.
I found a spot to lie low for a while, then managed to get a ride with a wagon of workers heading out to the fields. Abigail said she somehow managed to slip away when they grabbed Hosea.
You did good getting the others out of there. Keeping everyone together.
Everybody was pretty shaken up when I got back to Shady Bell. It was a tough few days. I couldn't have done it without Sadie.
So how did you find that spot back there? I assume the skulls on sticks weren't an addition of yours.
Old Strauss knew about it. The locals are terrified of the place, so we figured that might buy us some time. And it did. Until one of you brought the law with you.
And where did you end up again? Cuba?
Oh, not exactly. An island off of there, called Guarma. Landed ourselves in a heap of trouble.
Really? A tropical island? Isn't that just what Dutch wanted?
I guess it didn't exactly live up to his ideals. Anyway, I ain't always sure Dutch knows what he wants anymore.
Perhaps not, but he's always managed to figure things out in the past.
I know. Yeah, you're right. So just... it's been... guess I just miss Hosea and his wisdom, you know?
Of course. There's the bridge. There should be some canoes down to the right here. Well, I see one anyway, and that'll do. Come on. Okay, Butcher Creek is a few miles upriver. So I spent some time up this way while you were gone. I ran into Rain's Fall and Eagle Flies, the Indians. And I've been trying to help out a bit where I can at the reservation. Things are bad there.
That's not a surprise. They seem to be in a lot of trouble and heading into more.
Some men there spoke a lot about the Murphy gang that hides out in these caves. We're gonna need to be careful. They're animals. Everyone is terrified of them.
Great. Dutch didn't mention this.
Well, hiding up here, it's not a crazy idea. This is a spot nobody comes near, even the law. But just be ready. It won't be pretty.
So be it.
That's Butcher Creek up ahead.
Who are they?
The locals.
They don't look too friendly.
Wait till you meet the Murphys. All right, let's walk it from here. Good evening.
You know how we get to the caves at Beaver Hollow?
You'll get away if you know what's good for you.
Come on, they're not gonna help us. I'm pretty sure it's to the north, up the road here.
Can you help us? We're trying to find a spot called Beaver Hollow.
We don't take kind of outsiders around here.
These Murphy Hills, stranger. Might watch where you wander.
It's a bit of a walk. We could grab those horses if you want. Probably won't miss them if we get them back by morning.
Get up.
can see why folks don't want to come around here. Ain't exactly a welcoming place.
Lots of stories of people going missing around these parts. Just recently, a stagecoach from Annisburg disappeared without a trace coming through here.
Guess that's good for us. Assuming these inbred bastards are willing to part with their home, which I'm sure they won't be too pleased about.
No, but I believe they hide out all over Roanoke Ridge. These caves are just one of their spots, which is why we should keep it down. They might have lookouts around.
Okay.
You see that up ahead? Slow down, keep it quiet. It could be some of them. I say we dismount here and follow them on foot. See where they're going. Follow me, stay quiet. Let's get closer to them. Come on, up this way. Definitely Murfrees. I say we deal with them from here. You take one, I'll take the other.
For a bit, huh? How do I always gotta do the carrying?
Because I do the...
Stop!
Good job. We must be close now. Let's stop and have a look from the top of this hill there. Stagecoach went missing.
Jesus. They must be in the cave. All right. Let's get on with this.
Okay. What'd you think? We can head into the cave or flush them out with dynamite.
Dynamite be safer.
Yeah. Let's be quiet and... they don't come out. Let's get this over with. Get in a bit closer and then throw it into the cave.
Here they come!
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Let's get in there!
I'm aiming to see this old bitch die.
Keep them back, dammit!
Okay, Arthur! You were wrong about these crazy sons of bitches!
Touch me.
It's okay, miss. Just calm down. It's okay. It's okay. Shh. You're safe. Go. Where are you from?
Annisburg.
What do we do with her? You take her there and I'll go get the others.
Sure. Miss, you okay to ride on my horse a little? I'll keep you safe.
Annisburg, right?
Yes. They
It's okay, miss.
The others, they killed them.
You're safe now. Just try to breathe.
They're animals.
I know.
Are you sure this is the right way to Annisburg?
It's all right, miss.
Why would they?
Some folks is just evil. Ain't no point trying to explain it.
I haven't slept in days.
I know. What's your name, miss? It's okay.
Meredith.
You're gonna be home soon, Meredith. And this will all be over.
Thank you.
Where in Annisburg?
One of the mining cottages. If you get me to the main street, I can show you from there.
Okay. Just try to relax now. Yep.
Just head for the main street. It'll be easier to walk from there.
Miss.
Oh.
Here.
Oh. Thank God.
Which place is yours?
Up at the top of the hill. It's near the blacksmith.
Come on now.
Ma! Ma!
Meredith! She's alive! Oh, she's alive!
She saw some pretty bad things, I'm afraid, ma'am. Murphy Brew got
it. Oh, my God. How did you manage to?
I just ran into them and found her.
Oh, thank you. Here, let me give you this.
Oh, that's okay, ma'am. You just keep her warm and keep her safe. Mrs. Downs?
Oh, no. You leave me alone. You just leave me alone!
Thanks, buddy.
How you get on?
Okay. Found a girl.
Took her home.
Oh.
You and Micah find anything?
Maybe. I think maybe I found our old friend, Mr. Cornwall.
You did?
Yeah. He's buying a stake in the mine in Annisburg.
Relentlessly ambitious fella, isn't he?
Micah and I'll sniff about, see if he knows we're here, and exactly what his plans are.
So, Dodge, did you miss me?
I found her drunk in Saint Denis.
You're back. How jolly, Miss O'Shea.
It's funny, you suck of shit.
Back and drunk.
The master, the Lord
Molly,
God Almighty.
Calm down.
I won't be ignored. Dodge Vanderlyn, I am him. I ain't her. Or any of your stooges.
Calm yourself.
You don't owe me nothing.
Miss.
I don't owe you nothing. Nothing.
Okay.
I'll spit in your eye. I did. I told them.
I'm sorry?
Yeah, I told them, and I tell them again. Now I've got God's ear.
You told who what?
Mr. Milton and Mr. Ross about the bank robbery, and I wanted them to kill you.
You did what?
I loved you, you goddamn bastard! Go on, shoot me!
She's crazy. She ain't worth it. You told on me!
Oh, you're
you
not
betrayed
so big now,
me!
What?
Just calm down. Arthur!
She's a fool.
Get her out of here. You know the rules!
You're not so big now! Are we, Your Majesty?
You...
Damn!
She knew the rules, Arthur. What the hell is wrong with you? Mr. Pearson, Mr. Williamson, get this body out of here and get it burnt.
Okay.
Now get back to work, all of you! Quit your lollygagging!
Right.
Get back to work!
Woman, Miss Crenshaw, a nasty woman. You think I wanted to shoot her?
You seem to like her, son.
Beanie, look in here. You're drunk again, and you're a fucking murderer.
She broke the rules.
She did no such thing. She was in love. You sour-faced old crone. Goddamn you. Murderer! Murderer!
I did what I had to do, Mr. Morgan.
Perhaps. You okay?
What is happening to us?
I'm worried about you.
No, go away, Arthur.
Okay. Just want to make sure you're all right. Okay. Guess I'll leave you to it, then.
How you doing? Whatever you say.
How you doing?
Poor Molly. I don't believe it.
She knew the rules. Anyway, I'll leave you to it.
Okay, Arthur.
You okay, Tilly?
Molly got what she deserved. Nearly got us all killed.
Yep. She knew the rules. Well, try to keep your head straight.
All right. All right, Arthur.
You okay? About, Molly and everything?
She ratted on us. What could he do but look at this place?
No. Just hang in there for now. Well, don't give up on everything just yet.
I guess.
You okay?
I guess. I didn't really know Molly so well.
Thanks for your help. Well, securing this lovely spot. You okay, Reverend?
Yes. I will say a prayer for Miss O'Shea.
Say a prayer for all of us. Okay. Guess I'll see you later, then.
Be well.
I didn't see this coming.
Grimshaw did the right thing.
Well, let's just see where we go from here. Anyway, I'll leave you to it.
Sure, Arthur.
You look real good there, girl.
How you keep? Getting up in the morning's a real chore.
Now, you see, Helen, Acri here is a silly boy.
And Protus isn't a boy at all,
but a chimpanzee that a man shaves a face into every day. Now, that's very useful if you need to climb a tree, but a good conversationalist it does not make.
He was always a sickly child, sickly and weird. I have no idea why he followed me out to the West. He would have been better off staying at prep school or going to the seminary.
I've spent my whole life horsewhipping this scoundrel, but to no avail.
You can't punch, my sweet. It's sad, really. Oh, my, our friend.
Hello.
I bet you can punch. Do me and the lady a favor here, would you? And thrash this impudent wretch.
Thrash? No man alive can thrash me.
What was your name, sir?
Arthur.
Arthur could. Easily.
You, maybe, but not me.
I know. Punch us both as hard as you can. You'll break his glass jaw, and I'll be left standing. The knight and the knave.
Good idea. Hit me, then. Dear boy, give the feeble fellow a little tap and watch him crumble. Come on.
Ooh, caught me off guard.
You really walloped him.
My yikes! I'm fine.
Come.
Ooh, look there! I got a proper chin! Not like that toe rag.
Good Lord above!
Doesn't hurt.
Oh. Hey, hit me again!
Right here!
Right here! Oh!
Weren't you taught never to hit girls? Punch a man for once! Give me your worst. Here I step.
I think he's done for.
Barely even felt it.
Well, there's only one thing for it, then. Hit me in the manhood. Don't worry, sir. Mine are made of steel. Real steel, huh? No.
They've come out his ears! My turn! Come on, right there!
Enough, gentlemen?
Yes, I think so.
Oh, I slipped, and I hope you killed the leprechaun.
And he's still alive?
Shoot him, please, one of you.
There, up you get. We need to get some steak on those wounds.
Madam? Gentlemen, good luck to you.
Whatever got into your heads? Let's get you back to your room. Over here.
I'm fine, really. It's that wretch who needs the rest.
I've never been better. Truly, I could ride the strawberry in the state I'm in.
Both of you are going to bed, and that's the end of it.
A bath.
Wait.
Maybe that's what I need. Would you bathe me, sweet Helen?
Do you hear that wretch? That lascivious monster? If you're bathing anyone, you're bathing me. And
Hello.
You can be assured of my chivalry, fair girl.
Yes, that's right.
Here's the hotel. We're almost there.
Bidden this goat, you can be assured.
I need to get him
Hello.
To bed,
Welcome.
Okay? Goodbye, mister.
Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Pardon.
Hello, ma'am.
What's the deal?
Will you move?
Just a
Mr. Mason?
Oh, oh, Mr. Morgan.
You want to be careful up here. Land is real treacherous.
Sure.
Real treacherous. I've been here before.
Have you?
Yes. Funny how things turn out. Never quite how you expect, is it?
No, I don't suppose it is.
What you shooting?
Eagles. You know, the images, they really are beautiful. All thanks to you. I'd be some poor creature's bad meal by now, many times over, but for you.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Please, step away from the cliff edge.
But I'm trying to get an eagle there.
Yeah, they're beautiful. But unlike you, they can fly.
Too true. You really must think I'm a buffoon, don't you? You think I'm such a dimwit, I'd just slip off the edge of a cliff.
No, but, well, maybe a little.
Please, sir. I'm dense, but not that dense. This area is quite safe. Quite. Oh, oh!
Damn!
You are right. I am that much of a buffoon. Give me a hand, please. Put me out of my misery.
Come here.
Oh, thank you. You know what? Bugger the eagles, I'm going home. You know, I really did get some amazing pictures, thanks to you. And somehow, I haven't quite broken my neck.
You take care.
And you too, sir. Sorry for all the trouble. Good luck, sir. Although, as we both know, I'm the one who needs it.
The photographs. What are you gonna do with them?
Find somewhere to exhibit them, I guess. I should hope you'll come and view them.
Sure will. If I can.
The painter.
Okay. What are you dressed up like that for?
Oh, I am a wanted man, persecuted for my art.
As bad as it is, I don't think that the art is the problem.
In Paris, they say leave. Go far away. We will never understand you here. I say I go to Saint-Denis. They say that is not far enough. It seems to me that they were right. It doesn't matter. Now, I go to South Pacific. They always tell me the light there is perfect for my work.
So long as they weren't telling you that just to get you on the other side of the world.
Perhaps. It doesn't matter. Help me get to the next ship. They are watching the port, and I need a chaperone.
Okay, come on.
I'll tell you what I won't miss. Civilization! So repressive! So stifling! I can hardly breathe in this city!
Yeah, I kinda know what you mean.
Why I thought I would find my way in a country founded by Puritans, I'll never know. I know those men! I shot on their bar! Quick, behind here! Keep up! Keep up! Quick! We are away! Come now! Follow me!
Those fellas, you shat on their bar?
But of course! I needed to shit! Hey, come on! My fresh excrement was better than any of the drinks they served in there!
Remind me to avoid that place.
Back. The moneylenders. We go another way. We go through here. What's this? Quickly! It's nothing. I thought I knew him.
Please do not do that again. Now get moving, come on. So, wait. You ain't sold none of your work.
There is always a heavy demand for fresh mediocrity, but new kinds of brilliance, not so much.
The new kinds?
The Holy Nefant, we go through there.
Where are you going, pretty lady?
Anywhere you want, mon ami.
Oh my goodness.
This way, to the end of the docks.
I was going to buy the red ones to bring out the colors in your cheeks, but then I thought the...
Hush! Hey, I may know these people.
But maybe something gayer. A purple, perhaps? We are in Saint-Denis, after all. What are you looking at?
Bar shitting, money borrowing, wife stealing. You sure got a way of ingratiating yourself with people.
If the purpose of life was to be liked, it would be very boring indeed.
I've developed the feeling the purpose ain't to be hated.
Hate, love, they are the same. I provoke, I challenge, I amuse, do I not? With my impropriety, a mediocre life is meaningless. A bold life, filled with art and truth, dirty truth, that is something that matters.
Look at you, pretty little thing.
Hello, boys.
Come on.
Come on back now, baby.
Your garments might bring you...
I hope the sailors know who they're bunking with.
We have many weeks together. We will get to know each other well.
Well, good luck to all of you.
Relax. Hey, up here. She is my ship. We made it!
Let's go.
Oh, no, 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 no.
I got him. He's out here.
More friends? I'll deal with them.
I have another friend around here.
This ship's leaving soon.
Ah, merci, merci. All aboard for the South Pacific. Adieu. Merci, mon ami.
So long. If they don't like you in the islands, keep on going to the South Pole.
Ah, yes. I hear there the light is really fantastic. Au revoir.